overcome by the abiding word. 1 John chapter 2 and verse 14. I have written to you, fathers, because you have known him who is from the beginning. I have written to you, young men, because you are strong, and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the wicked one. John the Beloved is writing to believers. We don't exactly where he's writing, most likely towards the churches in Asia, Ephesus and other places. He's writing this letter that would be read among a group or a community of believers spread out in that part. And he's telling them, he says, you know, young man, I am confident of this. He says, young man, I'm writing to you because I know you are strong. Now, why are these young people strong? He says, the word of God abides in you and you have overcome the wicked one. So here we see a very important secret unveiled to us about living an overcoming life, of overcoming the wicked one, of not letting the devil run all over us, but having or living a life that is overcoming, living a life of victory, of being a person who is strong in God. He says, the word of God abides in you. So you are strong and you overcome the wicked one. You see, when the word of God abides in you, you know who you are in Christ. You know your position in Christ. You know the authority that you have in Christ. The enemy cannot deceive you. That's one of his major weapons, is lies and deceptions. But when you know the truth, the lies and the deceptions the enemy throws at you, they fall away powerless. They have no effect on you. His threats, his intimidations don't hurt you, don't harm you. You are so confident in who you are in God. You're full of the word. You're ready to use the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. You're ready to unleash God's weapon against the enemy because you have that word abiding in you. It's alive in you. It's not dormant. It's not something you heard a long time ago and you forgot. But the word of God is alive. It's dwelling in you. You walk in victory. You walk in authority. You walk in dominion. When temptations come, you immediately have the word of God with which you say it is written, and then you resist that temptation. When the enemy throws his fiery darts, you lift up your shield of faith. And remember, faith comes by the word and the word of God. So you lift up that shield of faith with which you're able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. So having that word abiding in us is so important to keep us strong and to enable us to live an overcoming life. Make time in your daily schedule. Make time through every day to feed your spirit with that word. Read the pages of scripture. Listen to sermons. These days you can get sermons everywhere. So many places that God's word is available for you to download, put on your phone, and you can listen when you're traveling, when you're going about from place to place. Keep listening to that word. Keep pouring that word into your spirit, because when the word of God abides in you, you're strong and you live a victorious life. You overcome the wicked one. Let's pray. Father, we pray and ask that you will stir up our desire, our passion for your word, so that the word of Christ will dwell in us richly, the word of God will abide in us, and that we will be strong and live victorious lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.